Thank you, Syar. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, everyone. Before we begin our presentation, let me introduce myself. My name is Felix Jermanto. I am the first author of this paper. I want to present our research. The title is Sentiment and Mobility Analysis on COVID-19 Restriction with Autoencoder. By myself as the first author and co-author, they are Merpati Fortuna Martenale, Nur Maulida, Bayu Chandra Putra, Stefania Hildegardis Bere, and Mr. Novanto Yudhistira. Part of presentation for this presentation, we are consists of introduction, material and methods, result discussion, and conclusion. Introduction. In the world was attacked by coronavirus disease 2019 or COVID-19, many countries implement targeted policies to prevent the spread of disease. The number of new cases of COVID-19 decreasing, so restriction implementation has begun to be relaxed. It can be seen the left feature. Although restrictions were set, there have been people who support or reject them. The people respond to COVID-19 restriction can be seen from their sentiment and mobility. Our work investigates the relationship between people sentiment and mobility as the response to COVID-19 restrictions since the pandemic emerged until restrictions were relaxed. Sentiment and mobility data is clustered using unsupervised learning autoencoder because the text and the time series data used are abstractive. Next, material and methods consists of sentiment text data to mobility time series data, word to fact autoencoder, LS time autoencoder, and two sample Z test for means. For material consists of two parts, for sentiment text data and second mobility time series data. For sentiment text data, sentiment data is obtained using the Twitter API. The tweet location is based on countries use English and have implemented restriction. This study is limited to 5 countries, namely Australia, Canada, Singapore, UK, and US. The keyword used are a COVID-19 restriction and the name of the country. For example, COVID-19 restriction plus Australia. We can see image on the right, the sample of search with keywords in the image above on the right. For the mobility time series data in this study are people mobility from time to time during COVID-19 pandemic. Find out mobility data will obtain from Google Mobility. The mobility time series was taken from 15 February 2020 until 9 May 2022. We can see an example the result of the mobility time series in the image on the right below. We can see 6 categories for mobility data, such as the retail and recreation, groceries and pharmacy, parks, transit station, workplace, and residential. For method, the method we use consists of 4 the methods, namely word to fact and autoencoder to process Twitter text data, then LSTM autoencoder to process Google mobility data, and the last two sample Z test to compare the result of 2 cluster from text cluster and time series cluster. Word to fact is model used to represent words into vectors, contents to model, skip gram, and continuous back of words. Autoencoder for dimensionality reduction to find the data hidden structure. And LSTM autoencoder is combination of autoencoder and LSTM. To Z-test for means for determine if difference between the two population mean is not statistically significant or not. For result, it consists of text data analysis, time series data analysis, and hypothesis analysis. Text data analysis. Twitter text data before being using by the autoencoder must be given the following action. First, clean off various words and symbols. Next, check the stop words and the last tokenization. After that, the data is processed by word to fact with parameter setting as follow: skip gram model size 1000 and min count is 1. Then the data processed by the autoencoder with the following architecture consists of 9 layers, 1 layer for input, 1 layer for 3 layer for the encoder, 1 layer for latent space, 3 layer for decoder, and 1 layer for output. We use optimizer of Adam, the loss function of binary cross entropy, batch size of 100 and epoch of 100. In the final stage, cluster visualization is conducted. Two-dimension latent space is determined by comparing the coordinate of x and y. If x greater y, then the choice is the first channel. Otherwise, if x smaller y, then the second channel is selected. The colors are blue for the first channel, and the red for the second channel, and a red for the second channel. Visualization result can be seen in the image on the right. There are five cluster image representing each country. Sequential from top to bottom are Australia, Canada, Singapore, the UK, and the US. For architecture autoencoder, we can see the bottom image as we described, consists of 9 layers. Time series data analysis. Google Mobility time series data use consists of 815 days with 6 categories. We set set of data become 815 and 6. But for LSTM autoencoder, we reset become 815, 6, and 1. We split to 60 and 40 for train and test. Then the data is processed with LSTM autoencoder with the following structure. One layer LSTM for input and with a 6 hidden, and 3 layer LSTM for the encoder. Latent space contains 1 layer of LSTM with 2 hidden units. 3 layer LSTM for the decoder, 1 layer for time distributed layer. We use optimizer of Adam, loss of MSE, epoch of 150. For the cluster visualization process is the same as text data. Visualization results can be seen in the image on the right. Sequential from top or to bottom are Australia, Canada, Singapore, the UK, and the US. Hypothesis analysis. To sample z-test for means to find out the relationship between clusters, hypothesis testing was conducted. To create a hypothesis, each cluster mean is compared. The null hypothesis is that the mean between the clusters is the same, and the alternative hypothesis is the mean between the cluster is not same. Comparison were made between blue text and blue time series to red text and red time series. In the right table, we can see in Australia, Singapore, UK, and US, it is known that the result of hypothesis are consistently rejecting the null hypothesis. But variance in the result occur in cluster in Canada. In Canada, comparison blue text and blue time series give the result the null hypothesis is accepted. Next, discussion. For discussion, test result show that many rejected the null hypothesis, but a small number accepted the null hypothesis from the Canadian. Based on the testing result between the blue text and blue time series cluster of Canada, the null hypothesis is accepted. In this work, we can get two different clusters, which we define into blue and red. Based on the text data cluster, we found a lot of neutral sentiment and blue text cluster, but primarily negative sentiments were found in the red text. The sentiment text example, we can see the top right table. The table on for the blue text cluster display tweets with neutral tweets. Well, in the second table, the red text cluster consists of neutral and negative tweets. For the mobile time series example data, we can see the right bottom image, the first graph from the blue time series, so a dynamic among the days. Well, in the second graph for the red time series cluster, the graph looks straight with a little up and down. The last part, conclusion. We have five conclusions. First, there are two clusters constructed from the autoencoder of text. One is a collection of text with neutral sentiment, while another is neutral and negative sentiments. Second, for the time series autoencoder, graph of dynamic community mobile become one cluster. The another cluster, so the graphs are consistent daily. Third, training data should be increased for future work, mainly for tweets. Tweets contained in each cluster can be used for labeling. Time series data should also be increased in terms of the mobility location variation. Fourth conclusion is from the research conducted, it can be seen that the relationship between people sentiment and people mobility in Australia, Singapore, US, and UK does not have a significant relation. But while in the Canada, it's seen the is a relationship between public sentiment and community mobility. This means Canadian people tend to be neutral in responding to COVID-19 while mobility is dynamic. I think that's all our presentation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much from Mr. Weldy and friends. Now we are continuing the question and answering. So the first chance I will give to the Mr. Ivan Yulfrian for ask the question. Please.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the time, Mr. Weldy. I see that your research is using Word2Vec to convert text into vector. And as far as I know, in Word2Vec, there are about two models. The first is Skipgram, and the other model is SIBO. My question is, why did you use Word2Vec using Skipgram to begin with? Thank you for the chance.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Ivan. I will try to answer. Yes, right. The Word2Vec contains two models. They are Skipgrams and SIBO, continuous back of words. Difference between them is about input and output data. The main difference between the two model is being the input output data, because the Skipgram model takes a word as input and predict its context as output. But SIBO does the opposite. It takes context and prediction the missing word. So Skipgram is excellent extracting the for semantic and grammatical characteristics of term, and therefore been widely applied in functional natural language understanding studies with good results, because that Skipgram is the appropriate we are choice for our paper. That's all, Mr. Ivan.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Mr. Weldy.
Okay, thank you very much. Is there any more questions before I